What's up, YouTube? It's your boy JD
and Jaspy
back with another reaction. This time is for Kris Wu
November Rain.
He just had an album come out. He's doing a lot of press in the U.S. He's been doing a lot of big things within the last year in general. So
we reacted to him and Janae last time, right?
Yeah, it was. But we gonna give him another chance because I like him. Kris Wu, November Rain. Let's get into it.
Come on, product placement. I wonder who he's signed to.
That's interesting though.
This is a ballad. November rain just made me feel so lonely. So sad when I can't see my shawty. Know the driver, they can be my shawty. Cause I fall for you at these times.
Remind me of Post Malone a little bit.
Or Travis Scott.
Okay. He worked with Travis Scott. So
who drives in circles and smokes a cigarette?
Kris Wu. Well, a little bit of Drake in it. I can never ever hate or know about them. Got my haters asking God, please want him. Put in too much work to worry about them. Everything around me and you but my friends, yeah. Cause I fall for you at these times. November rain just made me feel so lonely. So it's not when I can't see my shawty.
As hell.
I really like the chorus.
Yeah. I feel like had Post Malone and Travis Scott did this song, it would have been everything. Yeah. But I just don't believe him. If you get what I'm saying, like
it's not like somebody else wrote it.
It looks
for him.
Forced. He looks uncomfortable.
And a little bit of Drake in there too. All I can hear is Travis Scott. Like
in Post Malone.
Yeah,
that's their sound. It sounds forced. It don't. This chorus is everything though.
Yeah, it's a beautifully written song. But just like the melody, I just can't help but hear Travis Scott or either one of them sing this.
This is one of them songs where I would rather listen to it without the video. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Without a visual, I could live without the visual. The song is good, but just sing it.
Like, this probably would be a better live performance to get into it.
I don't even think a live performance. I just feel like this video was too
somber.
No, it was too bright. I feel like it should have been darker, like at night in the garage lit up maybe or something.
And it would have been better. Yeah. So what do you think? Wait, hold on. Oh, still a little bit.
A little bit of product placement.
Yeah.
Come on, Beats.
Okay, so I got a lot to say, so go ahead. What do you think about it?
I didn't like the video. I didn't like his look. It was very... Far East meets... I don't know if you ever seen that movie with Nicolas Cage, Con Air, with all the comics on the plane.
Yeah, with the hair.
It just looked very... Like, imagine if Jackie Chan was in that movie with him. Mm. And you put them together. That's what it was giving me. It was giving me, like, bad action.
I don't know about that. I don't know.
The look just didn't look... It was a... He had a fucking mullet.
Yeah. I don't know. Is it me? Or does it seem like in K-pop in general, the whole career, everybody's trying to make mullets popping again because they put the mullet on chin.
Well, it looked bad. His lips were chapped.
And the video didn't make any sense. You saw a glimpse of a girl for like a split second.
Yeah.
He was driving in circles, smoking a cigarette. What did that mean? He was in a diner 1 minute. He's on a plane the next. Okay.
So this is how I feel. I like the song.
I love the song.
I like the video, but it's kind of like you said, it doesn't really help the song. It doesn't help the song. Yeah. It doesn't help the song. And like I said, I like the song. I like Kris Wu, but it just, it
was forced.
Like, for me, I promised the guy, as he was singing it, I was like, all I could hear was Travis Scott
and
or like a
Post Malone.
And how better they would sound.
Or even a Bryson Tiller.
Yeah. But I mean, I think he's kind of, I know he's kind of inspired by
it. I don't think he knows his sound. I don't think Kris Wu knows his sound.
That's what I can kind of get to, because I mean, with him and that Travis Scott song they did, it was lit. It sounds like,
because I think he could be somewhere in between EXO
and Travis Scott. Yeah, and meet him
but
in the middle.
But he left EXO, so he doesn't want to go to where he...
All the way
he
there.
He doesn't want to go home.
Yeah, because a lot of times, like, with his solo stuff, it feels like he's holding back his talent.
I feel like he feels uncomfortable. I think he wants that pop that EXO has with a touch of this.
Because he can dance, too.
He can dance.
He has
a decent voice.
Yeah.
I mean, he is the phone. I hope you find yourself, Kris Wu.
Yeah. Because we're rooting for you, buddy.
Yeah, you're a former EXO.
Like, but he does have a good following. He's been trying to...
I mean, clearly, because he was top of the charts until they snatched him.
Yeah, until they did them investigations. Yeah, well, I guess we can get into it now. Because, allegedly, they were saying that the fans...
Were making bots.
Yeah. And buying his album.
To influence it.
Yeah.
To keep Ariana from going number one.
Yeah.
But it did not work.
Mm-hmm. What did Nene say?
You can never win when you play dirty.
You can never win. That's what she said.
And then on top of that, as a artist, if I was Kris Wu, I would feel some type of way. Uh-huh. Because you didn't earn it.
He said, from the snippet I saw, he said he didn't know that. And like, I think they're saying like he's actually planning to countersue. Because it is kind of slander.
Yeah.
Which... We don't know.
Like, if my fans figured out a way to hack it to make me go number one, I would be like, hold on.
Hey, y'all.
Just buy it.
But that's the thing, though. That's what I'm seeing they're saying is the problem, that they're Chinese fans. It's one thing if the Chinese fans or Asian fans, they bought it in China, and we're just looking at China iTunes charts, that's fine. But they managed to, from China, to buy it on the U.S. charts, to make his album chart on the U.S. chart. Yeah.
So
it's like, if it was just reflected in the Chinese
based on regions, it stays there. So they were somehow able to
get back into the U.S.
sales into.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I think in that case, hack away.
You're so stupid.
Hack away.
Yeah. Shit, they should have hacked Tinashe sales.
Tinashe, can we get some help for Sierra?
Oh, no, I ain't gonna say that.
Oh, yeah. She on her own.
You know, yeah.
Yeah, but,
it was...
I don't know.
Great song, bad video. Kris Wu just needs to find himself.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
Just keep at it, buddy. Just keep at it.
Just go back to what you know. Like, you don't have to be XOXO, but just...
That's why I feel like he's trying, because he's trying to get away from that.
He could have been on a don't switch up my tempo vibe and fuck the whole game up. You know what I'm saying? That's where I can see him.
He can dance.
That's where I can see him. Because it still has that trapness to it.
Mm-hmm.
But doing this, it's going to seem forced, and nobody's going to connect with you over here. Cause they're gonna like what is this?
And it's a double edged sword. Cause kind of with Lay, he's just strictly doing him, and he's bringing it over here. But I can kind of see where he's going. He's trying to appeal.
But Lay's sound sounds like Lay.
Yeah,
and you can tell where his roots were from.
Yeah,
but this is just like, dude, what the hell?
Kind of sound like
they gonna be like, I'm like, who's this little Asian boy singing this trap music?
And that was the thing, like, as I listened to the song, like, I liked the song, but it's just like, I kept hearing Travis Scott
or Post Malone.
I feel like if Post Malone did it, number one. It would have been number
Travis
one.
Travis Scott, number one.
Yeah.
It's a great song. Uh-huh. It really is. It really is a great song.
Yeah.
But I just don't think it's a Kris Wu song. I don't think
it's kind of like with what you call it when Bridget Kelly covered Frank Ocean, when Frank Ocean gave her
thinking about you.
Yeah.
You remember, like, he initially he wrote that song for her.
Right.
But once they people heard the demo, they were like, oh, we like this better because it sounds
authentic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's why I feel like, I know he's had Travis Scott write for him before. I feel like if we heard the Travis Scott reference,
it would probably be sickening.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just not authentic. And if it's not connect with the audience, it's just a flop.
Yeah.
Sorry.
We want to see, you know, let us know how his album
Kris
did.
Kris Wu. Woo woo.
Woo woo woo.
Woo woo woo.
If you like this, look, I know y'all, this is an honest reaction.
Very.
They not paying us.
It is what it is.
It is what it is.
If you like this video, click subscribe.
Yes.
Follow us on, y'all know where to find us.
Instagram and Twitter and all that.
But yeah.
If you don't like it, we can fight in the comments.
Right. Y'all do it anyway. Bye.
Bye.